Absolutely, absolutely. Welcome, welcome once again to the Made in Compton Store podcast. That's micpt.com. Well, how are you today, the owner of the one and only Made in Compton Store?
Oh, I'm doing good.
That's good. Good to hear as always. So now tell me, what is it like when you think about Sundays? Everybody thinks about the lowriders and the music, the parks, the good food, and so forth. What is it like to have a store on a Sunday?
Oh, it's pretty much a kickback day. Like, communicate with the customers, see what they need, see what anything new we can add to our catalog.
Nice. You gotta love it. So, what was something that you can share with us that was really insightful? I mean, I'm sure, you know, there's a plethora of information that we always learn that can be insightful. But something that really you think that can help others that was insightful for you when you first started your business?
At first I said, you know, we was just going to do t-shirts, but then it came to the point where it was like people wanted to have a combo, ensemble. So it's like, now it's time to dress a mannequin. Got to get it from head to toe. And that really just opened things up.
Wow. Okay. So I tell you that it's something extraordinary to be able to, like, say for instance, it's one thing to have a store and then get and use customers' responses, input, and then actually showcase their input. Have you had that experience where a customer shared information with you and then they came back to the store and seeing that you had implemented it?
Yeah. With the Compton 1888, established 1888, it was a customer that told me, and the Walmart, they had all the different cities in the established years. Mm-hmm. And he was like, but he couldn't find Compton. So I said, oh, there you go.
Wow. How neat then is that?
He came back and seen it. He was like, oh, man, you owe me. So I gave him the shirt for free.
Okay. Absolutely. Now, that's paying attention. And, you know, one thing about just like the students that are on that winning team, they won the 2022-2023 championship for the Dream program. Absolutely. That's something I was sharing with them as well when they were doing the interviews, that to be a great listener and then actually implement what someone is sharing with you to help you is really, really, really phenomenal. So, and I see, I mean, I tell you, one of my favorite videos that I did myself is the one where I was just amazed. I was like, I never thought about it too, thinking about, you know, when was my city or the city I grew up in, learn how to read and write, all that and everything, you know, established. And out of all of this research I've done and so forth as a teacher and everything, and I thought that was really neat. So I'm so glad that you did that. And you have them in all different colors. And the V-neck, the crew neck. You did that. Absolutely, you did. I was like, that's great. So, and is there another experience that you had that's similar? Or not similar, but just another experience of somebody sharing some wealth of knowledge and it has helped you?
Yeah. It's when we did start doing the schools.
And that's one of the things, connecting again, like you said, to the community. And that's really part of that youth and sports calls that you have in the store, obviously. So, because you deal with you deal with elementary through high school, right?
Yeah.
Nice. So with that said, when you think about business and working with the community for, you know, helping everybody to feel great, because you do feel great. You feel better than what you did the day before when you do have a new t-shirt on, or, you know, a form of comfort clothing, because it could be a beanie too, you know what I'm saying? So at the same time, or a jog or anything. So at the same time, what is it? What does it mean to you when you, or can you just give us some insight of what you're thinking when you see us walking around with your attire, the merchandise from your store?
Oh man, at first I used to be starstruck. I used to be like, oh wow, he wearing a t-shirt. One of our shirts.
Wow.
Especially the further out you see him, the more it's like, wow.
Wow, that's pretty neat.
I took my son to Disneyland one year, and I seen some people wearing some of the stuff.
Wow. That
and
was
it was so like, cool. Wow, we was like comparing our shirts.
Oh, that's too precious. Absolutely. Now, that's really neat. Now, when you think about it, too, oh, my goodness. I'm so excited. I tell you, the know that there are so many people that come on the tour from different countries. Now, have you received any pictures, or what has the follow-up or some experience have you had from somebody that went back home with a Compton attire? You know, whether it was a t-shirt, a mug, a beanie, and so forth. What can you share one of those experiences with us?
Yeah, so you know the tour come through. Mm-hmm. So I'll be having people like from Australia, they send me stuff where they back at home wearing the Compton stuff.
Oh, wow. So what's an example? What do they have that they send to you?
Be pictures of them wearing the Compton stuff.
Okay.
And that's... like areas that's known, like on the Gold Coast of Australia, at the beach.
Got you. Nice. Now that's really cool. Now that's something that, I wish I could compile some type of, well, now, you know, back in the day we would say album book, but now that would be neat to have some type of website or some type of something. I have to think about that, but that's really neat to be able to see through that, because that's something I would love to like flip through, because I've been to some other events and they have a book, and then they like, do you want to be part of the book, you know, do you want to take a picture here and then we could put you in the book or something, and you know, so it's just different things, because that's really extraordinary to have so many people from so many different countries to visit your store. Come on.
Yeah, we showcase some of them, like when people send me the pictures on the Instagram, on the Made in Compton store page.
Okay, very good. That's cool. Absolutely, because that's really neat. And then just to think about the people, like someone like the one young man, Ross the Boss, that came into the store, and I thought he looked like he was doing something, and he's like, I said, what sport do you play? And he said football, but he said it so nonchalantly that I was like, oh, okay. And then but come find out the young man was going around every city and getting a t-shirt, and he came to Made in Compton store to get his t-shirt, and he's going to another state. He was going to another state the next day. I was like,
oh, nice.
Yes, absolutely. And then because I was so excited about it and for him and everything, he was like, are you on Instagram? And I was like, yeah. And so he tunes into the store. I sometimes do Instagram videos and everything, and he's on the line. And I was like, I thought that was pretty cool. So it's like, we, you know, sometimes in some places you have so much fun, or, you know, some people, when, you know, you notice when people are genuinely excited for you and so forth. And I think that registered in the young man. So when I go live, the young man's on live. He had so much fun. And then I tell you, it was just like, he's like, oh man, I'm on a budget, you know, but he wanted to change his whole game, because it was like the keychains, it was the slippers. He's like, oh, but I can't fit these. And then it was like the podcast, and then I want the mug. You know, it was like he wanted everything, but he had to stick with his budget and get the t-shirt. So that day, and then, you know, with the traveling, this, you know, parent affording all those different things. So, but I believe it's wonderful that just like those children that came and did an interview, they have that experience a childhood experience that they're going to remember. That's their first experience. I tell you, what made you even create the fact that you wanted to have microphones for the Made in Compton story?
We were shooting an independent film, and we wanted to do our own, like, newscast.
Okay. I tell you, that's really neat. And, you know, because I use it, I'm telling you, I'll be on Facebook with it. Absolutely. And so when I was like, wait a minute, the students, they should be able to do interviews and so forth. And I was like, yeah. And I was like, oh, man, I'm so happy to see those. You have the two microphones. And I was like, oh, wow, this is so cool. It's like, you are just really immersed into the community. And I'm like, I just want to say thank you for that as well, too. Because it's not the regular situation. Because we all know, we go to other stores. I'm not going to name them. But you don't feel the sense of community or, you know, do you really care? I have to work for this money. You know what I mean? And you just going into the store and you're a number. So, you know, yeah, absolutely. Definitely. And I know I'm not speaking for everybody, but I know it's quite a bit of people that feel the same way. We appreciate that because we understand. And at the same time, I know it has to be something that you want to share with the audience that you can share a plethora of things because you have so much experience as being a store owner. Now, we are all know we want to keep the lights on and everything. So now, if it was something that you want to inspire or, you know, just even motivate a young kid that's thinking about, oh, man, I want to have my own store, just like the young man that was there. And he was like, oh, I want to have my own store. I'll have my own fashion. You know, I'm drawing pictures already, and he's only 11 years old. What would you share with him?
I would say start your LLC. Keep working on the graphic designs till you come up with something that the people like, and then mass produce.
Wow. Let me see what other question I can ask you. Absolutely, because I'm like, whoa, I need to go back and listen to that and write down number one, number two, the step three. Absolutely, for me too. Amen and amen. You got to love it. Well, at this point in time, I want to let you know again that this is really extraordinary to have the MICPT.com podcast. That's something. Let me just ask this last question for this podcast today. Let me ask you, why did you consider doing a podcast with me that talk so much?
To spread the word.
Amen, amen. Absolutely, good word. Because I tell you, I know that this is an extraordinary opportunity for me, so I'm glad, because I'm doing just that. And anybody that's listening, even right now, because I know that sometimes we're live, and then other times we do the webinars or they're called. We're listening to them after the original live show has occurred, and you're chatting with us. That I want to tell you that I appreciate this opportunity so everybody will know, because it is really something phenomenal when you get a chance to work with somebody that has such extraordinary experience. And anybody that knows me, they know I've always wanted to be in business. So this is great, and a great experience. So I just want to tell you thank you so much once again. All right?
All right. You're welcome.
Amen and amen. And we're going on with the Studio All-Stars right here. Absolutely. So you all have a good time and tune in and share the show. Absolutely.